Welcome, everyone. We are in Las Vegas at the Tom Devlin's Monster Museum. Definitely some cool stuff in the shop alone. So, let's check out the museum itself. People I came with are in a little bit of a hurry, so they left me over here anyway. This is definitely really interesting. Nice to go somewhere like Vegas and end up still feeling like home with horror items and everything. My twin brother right there. You laughing about that? Oh, this is cool. Anybody that truly knows me knows that the Wolfman is my favorite of the Universal Monsters. Frankenstein meets the Wolfman is my favorite of the Universal Monster movies. This is my type of place. I definitely do agree on that. There's no flash allowed in here as well, so sorry about it being any, if it's too dark. Oh, I hear the Exorcist theme. I hope I don't see Linda Blair here. Some autograph stuff too, because they go to Days of the Dead conventions as well and work with them. So definitely a lot that you end up seeing from that, but damn, I'm really loving this place. Oh, that grandpa from Texas Chainsaw. There's little Fred. Ash. Nadine and Peter. Two other monsters. Not so little Mikey. My goal, one of my goals someday, is to meet this man before he stops going to conventions or just try to. What, him? No, this is supposed to be, I think, Grandpa from Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Oh, yeah. Okay. Played by John Dugan, if I said his last name correctly. John, I apologize if you see this. I plan on posting it on my Facebook as well, so you might see it. I'll get there. I'm more Texas Chainsaw Massacre stuff here and this Michael Myers Strode stuff and whatnot. This is amazing. Oh yeah, Behind the Mask. I really hope that prequel ends up being able to be made, because Before the Mask, I'm excited about that too. And this is that haunt stuff, isn't it? Or strangers. What's my room? Oh, the Friday the 13th room. Yeah, it might be my room. course, the masks.
This is screen used.
What is it?
Spider Gremlin from Gremlins 2.
Oh, that is awesome.
This is screen used. He didn't create this, someone else did, but...
Yeah, they have a NECA. I mean, that's definitely not the NECA. The NECA is a lot smaller. But they have a NECA. They do in-store signings, too. Unless that's from a different store, but... Looks like CJ Graham around here, which he's going to be at Des Moines Con in September. Oh, look, it's Ghostface. Hello, Sydney. Oh, poor Sydney. When you're friends with Sydney, you die.
Pain and suffering.
Hellraiser?
Huh?
Hellraiser?
Yep.
Spider Gremlin from Gremlins 2. That is awesome. Gets a whole room to himself. Gizmo. And this is an amazing wall, too. The I Love New York poster from Jason Takes Manhattan. Signed, of course. I know it's not regarded as being a great... Alright, I'll be there in a minute. A great... mention that Michael Berryman stuff is over there. So... They don't regard that as being a great movie for part 8, but I still enjoy it with parts, and I also have a piece of Jason's screen outfit from it. Alright, so now into the Hellraiser room. We have eternity to know your flesh. No tears. It is a waste of good suffering. I know I missed the please part in there, but this is awesome. Michael Bailey Smith from the Hills Have Eyes remake. And also played Super Freddy from Part 5 of Nightmare on Elm Street. Oh, Chucky dolls. And Tiffany. Oh, that leprechaun looks cool. I'll show you guys in a second here because I'm... Also got to show you the amazing Michael Berryman Hills Have Eyes... So, 2 years ago, or no, it's 3 years ago almost now, got to work with Michael Berryman at the Crypticon Minnesota convention as his handler. He was an amazing guy. I met him once before, but I got to actually spend time with him and talk to him. A lot of stories and very amazing to work with. So first I will show you the leprechaun. This is really well done. Horror music throughout Hellraiser now. And here's Candyman. Tony Todd's another great actor and awesome to meet. And of course, Currywise. Tim Curry's Pennywise the Clown from Stephen King's 1990 It miniseries. Oh, and that's awesome too. So yeah, that's what the music is from, by the way. It's Hellraiser's Killer Clowns from Outer Space.
Kurt.
Oh yeah, I'll get there in a second. No, Brian will like to see that part. Do 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 do. And we get over to the Ghoulies too. Somebody really had some bad Taco Bell to create that. And on to one of my other favorite series of little monsters. Puppet Master. You have not. I think all of them are on Tubi because it's, you know, full moon stuff. All of it almost seems like it's on Tubi, which is great because you get to view it, but we'll have to get to it. Oh, Freak Show as well.
Poultrygeist.
Oh, yeah, I've seen that too. That was the, or they had Thanksgiving as well, but I was gonna say that was one of the Thanksgiving was the, like, the one of the only Thanksgiving movies before the Eli Roth movie came out. Screen used edition. The, what is that, ginger weed or whatever that was called or something? Maybe there's the ginger dead man with the Gary Busey face. Evil Bong. Mega Piranha, Killjoy. A lot of effects went into a lot of this stuff. There's a Poultrygeist. Poultry. How's it going, man? Fist bump. Surprised you didn't spend more time around Sam here.
I know. He'd probably got a picture of him.
There's Linda. And there's Sam from one of the greatest horror anthologies of all time. And Toxie. Oh, they're watching Planet Terror in there. Creature from the Black Lagoon. Raku Browning was amazing too. Sad about his passing. Ed Lagoon is there. Say it once. Say it twice. Three times the charm. And Lily, it's Herman. I am finally meeting Butch Patrick in September. Very excited about that too. And so, Lon Chaney Jr., one of the greatest actors of all time as well, and my favorite Universal monster actor. A goal would be, on an awesome scale, to get his autograph from some kind of legit memorabilia piece. More critter stuff. Hunchback of Notre Dame. So, Lon Chaney Sr., Lon Chaney Jr.'s father, of course, was a horror actor before Lon Chaney Jr. and was in some amazing things, such as Phantom of the Opera and The Hunchback of Notre Dame. Oh, I want this. I really want this. But even as well, I'd love to have a screening room like this too. Hey, you guys, can we add an addition onto the house and create a screening room like this? I know. I mean, I'll provide my projector for it. Well, it looks like a bunch of a creep show. Oh, yeah, Tom Savini did do the makeup for Ari Lehman in Friday the 13th. No, I'm sorry, that's Ari fucking Lehman. Is this the end of the...
Yeah.
Alright, folks, well, that is the end of this. This is probably the longest video I've actually made. I usually just do unboxing videos or... as possible, but thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. I definitely did. I want to move to this place, but you guys take care and keep being spooky.